What's up, YouTube? This is Barnon11970, and I thank you as always for watching my video. Alright guys, as you can see by the title of this video, I'm changing gears a little bit into something that I think is really important, and I find it funny how they kind of sneak things in when there are problems going on throughout the world. It's the whole smoke and mirrors of our government. This is what they love to do. So, I will of course provide the link for this video if you do want to read it yourself, otherwise just stick around here and I will read the article. This title of this article is Monsanto Protection Act Sneaks Through the Senate. Non-GMO groups are furious over the measure, saying it backs biotech and agribusiness over farmer and consumer safety. Gotta love our government. All right. When the Senate passed a budget resolution Wednesday that appears to prevent some of the potential damage from sequestration, the continuing resolution included several food and agriculture-related earmarks. But one inclusion in particular is especially controversial. The biotech rider would require the USDA to approve the harvest and sale of crops from genetically modified seed, even if a court has ruled the environmental studies on the crop were inadequate. Isn't that nice? This bill, this aspect of the bill infuriated many sustainable food and agricultural groups, who nicknamed the bill the Monsanto Protection Act. If signed into law by President Obama, here's what the rider would do. It would allow farmers to plant, harvest, and sell genetically engineered plants, even if the crops have been ruled upon unfavorably in court. A Center for Food Safety statement called the rider an unprecedented attack on U.S. judicial review of agency actions and a major violation of the separation of powers. But perhaps more frightening, other critics say, is the rider threatens the health and well-being of the public by undermining the federal court's ability to protect farmers and the environment from potentially hazardous genetically engineered crops. The rider was slipped into the bill while it sat in the Senate Appropriations Committee, chaired by Maryland Democrat Barbara Mikulski. According to the Center for Food Safety, the committee held no hearings on this controversial biotech rider, and many Democrats were unaware of its presence in a larger bill. That's because they never read the bills. They just sign them, because if you're labeled a Democrat, you have to go with other Democrats. If you're labeled a Republican, you have to go according to other Republicans, because God forbid they actually speak their own mind and go against even their own party when it comes to the people. Because last time I checked, our government is supposed to be a representation of the people, not their political party and agenda. Anyway, all right. In this hidden backroom deal, Senator Mikulski turned her back on consumer, environmental, and farmer protection in favor of corporate welfare. What a surprise, for biotech companies such as Monsanto. Andrew Kimbrell, executive director of the Center of Food Safety, said in a statement, "This abuse of power is not the kind of leadership the public has come to expect." All right, I'm just going to end it right there. You could read the rest if you want to. If we say nothing, then you know what? Our grandkids, our kids, they're the ones that are going to suffer, because when these laws get passed, and it hasn't been passed yet, but if they're sneaking the stuff under the table, we know that if it's left unheard, they're going to pass it. Now, is that a guarantee? Absolutely not, especially if we all decide to say enough is enough and we stop letting these goddamn people do whatever the hell they want in this government. Unless you don't mind having your kids and your grandkids eating a bunch of genetically modified crap that will poison them and kill them. Just not kill them right away, because the government, this is the one thing you have to understand about the government. They need slaves. They need the people to run the machinery. So they don't want you sick and die right away, because then you're not productive. They want you to gradually get sick, so you wear down, and then once you get to the age where you're not really productive for them to make money off of you, then they can give two shits about you and just dump you in some home, or if you're some vet, they just don't care about you, because, you know, you could serve your country while you're useful. When you're not useful anymore, they just throw you away and they don't care about you. But they'll throw a parade every now and then and, you know, salute a flag to show that they really care. So here's the thing, guys. We could ignore this. we could fight amongst ourselves, which everybody seems to love to do, or we can actually start, you know, messaging the people in this government and start saying no more. No more rallies, no more marches. How about we all throw these people out? When was the last time we had a good chance of impeachment of a president? If he signs this into the bill into law, and obviously, like I said, they're sneaky about this stuff. Look at how they did the National Defense Authorization Act, which gives the authority to kill American citizens without trial. And ladies and gentlemen, not only did they pass it the first time on Christmas Eve, when they redid it last year, they did the same exact thing. Because they like to do these things when the average person is too concerned about getting drunk and partying than giving a shit about its country and its future. So you may not care about this now, but I am damn well sure your kids and your grandkids and so on will give a shit about the fact that we, the people, and I include myself in this if I don't act on this, and that's why I'm making this video to get the information out, that we didn't give a shit about their future. I wish we can all work together and get along with this and see that the government doesn't give a shit about you. It cares about corporations and money, and they care about everything but you. They care about how much money they can put in their pockets, how much power they can get, and how much freedoms can they get away with stealing before we actually rise up and do something about it. So, if you don't want to spread this information, if you don't want to make a video on it, well, then obviously the government can get away with everything. If you're sick and tired of the bullshit that they're doing just to earn a buck, then I hope you guys will at least make a video, share this video, or go to your local congressman and say enough is enough. I leave that up to you. I'm here to spread information. What you do with it is up to you. I find this very sickening. Better start learning how to grow your own food, people. Peace.